So I'm rocking the Kylie Cosmetics Power Plush Concealer. It's super hydrating and weightless, brightens, blurs and smooths for up to 12 hours. And can we please just take in this tapered brush? It's like the perfect application. I'm obsessed.
MC, make another hit. Whoa.
This ain't what you want. Project, this ain't what you want. This ain't what you want.
Hey guys, so I wanted to share my favorite products and the shades that I use. Charlotte Tilbury Flawless Filter in the shade 8, which gives me a nice little glow. Makeup by Mario, Sorrel Skin Foundation in the shade 26N. Tarte Shape Tape Concealer in the shade Deep. Fenty Beauty in the shade Espresso. Fenty Beauty in the shade Mocha Mommy for a bronzer. Lucky Rare Beauty, Sephora Collection Date Night. Huda Beauty Banana Bread. Let me know if you want a makeup tutorial on this look. You better lock your phone. I'm looking in the mirror. Won't take a lot to get you going. I'm sorry if it's touching you.
Fragrance takes over the room. Can I call you? carved top brow, carved bottom brow, on the side, middle, all over lid, forehead, bridge of nose, cupid's bow, chin. Concealer on inner corner, concealer on outer corner, brain together, and other side. Concealer below jawline, cream contour on forehead, cheekbones, jawline, sides of nose, eye crease, and other side. Blending from top to bottom, forehead, eyes, nose contour, under eyes, cheekbones, cupid's bow, chin. Add a little bit of your foundation, blend everywhere. Some liquid blush, blend. Fill in eyebrows, set under eyes, the cheekbones, brown eyeshadow, nude eyeshadow, shadow wing, a pair of lashes, powder bronzer, blush, lip liner, lipstick, and you're done.
Are we foundation shade twins?
This is your sign to try a darker foundation. Yes, I said darker. If you like a full glam look, going a shade darker is definitely going to help everything come together so much better at the end. I feel like there's low-key a stigma about wearing a foundation shade darker than your skin tone, especially in Black and brown communities, because of like all of the emphasis on whiteness in beauty. Like, let's be real, they're still selling bleaching creams in Africa and my home country of Nigeria, all over Asia. There is still very much this push to promote whiteness as a standard of beauty. So I'm here to tell you, wearing a darker foundation is okay. Once you add your concealer, your bronzer, and powder, everything comes together so much more nicely. Just don't forget to apply a healthy amount of setting spray and a setting powder that matches your skin tone. For the longest time, I did not get the hype behind lip oils because most lip oils look like this. Like, I mean, my lips look good, but Vaseline can do that. Pigment wear. Then I started to realize that not all lip oils are created equally. Some of them actually do have enough pigment for a dark-lipped girly like me. First up, the NYX Lip Drip Fat Oil. They have a decent amount of colors, and I love this brown shade called Status Update. Kosas also has a bunch of good shades in their lip oils, and the formula has a good amount of shine. This glittery shade Exposed with some lip liner. Perfect for holiday. The last two on my list function basically the same way. They are lip oils that are also lip stains. These are going to be considerably more affordable. These are by Oma by Sharon C. They are marketed as lip tints, lip oils, and/or lip gloss. Literally, the product's name is it's complicated. You'll definitely get a lot more pigment with these. Maybe not as much like shine, but definitely pigment. This is the shade Boasty. Last but not least, we have these from Rare Beauty. Again, Love the formula, lots of pigment. I feel like this is the only lip collection where I like almost every single shade. These do dry down a little bit darker than what they first apply like. This, some liner and some extra gloss. Matter of fact, let me do that right now. It actually doesn't even need any extra gloss. And by the way, this is in the shade Wonder. Quick little addendum, I'm trying these right now and these seem promising. These are the new e.l.f. lip oils and this is in the shade Jam Session. And she's real cute. Hope this helped.
Doing a full face of She Glam makeup today. And guys, there's so much stuff in here. Oh my god, I don't know where to start. So the brow pencil wasn't my shade, so I used something else to fill it in. This is too light for me, so we're gonna go to over to the concealer. I got these two shades. I got the shade Caramel and the shade Earth. Extremely light, but we're gonna make it work. This is the color Earth, and as you can see, it's like super lighter than I expected. One thing I can say, it's really full coverage as they said, but the color is not doing it. Now that we got the brows done, applying my Milk primer. This is their long-lasting breathable matte foundation. I think I'm gonna try the color Sandalwood. And as I said, I tried their foundation out already, and their foundation is really good. Using the concealer again, I'm gonna try an itty bitty dot under my eye because it's too light for me. So we're not gonna apply too much. Concealer really does the job though. I wish I got a better color, but I love the concealer. I love me some blush, so I'm really excited about these blushes. Let's see what color we're gonna use. I heard so many great things about their blushes, so it smells good. This is so pretty, y'all. It's not doing too much. I like it. I'm almost done with my makeup and I'm sad. I want to try this liquid highlighter, and it's really pretty. I tried it on my hands already. A little dot. Let me see. I'm gonna blend it out with my fingers. Ooh, I like it. Ah! So guys, this is the finished look. I love it, guys. I'm obsessed. I love the foundation the most because it does what it needs to do. And what do you guys think? Let me know in the comments because I'm feeling it.
Hey, my babes. So you've been wondering how I get this high arch when I'm doing my eyebrows. Let me show you what I do. First, I start by mapping my eyebrows. Now, when you're doing your first mark, you want to get that first mark to be your lowest point. And you're gonna start at the side of your nose, going straight up. And we're putting our first mark here, and this is going to be our lowest mark. This is important because the lower mark helps you to get that higher arch. When you're mapping your eyebrows, when you're gonna connect this first mark to your second mark, which is going to be your highest mark, you will get that higher illusion. So our second mark, we're gonna be placing as our highest mark. We're gonna start at the side of the nose again, and we're just gonna pivot that pencil just like this, going to the center of my eyes. And I'm just gonna go all the way up to where I want that mark to be. So I could bring it down lower if I want, still being a little bit higher than that first mark. Or I can bring it high as I want, and it would be higher than the first mark, either way. But it depends on how high you want your arch. You're gonna place your second mark, but it has to be higher than the first mark. So we're gonna go ahead and mark. And our last mark should be lower than the second mark. So we're just gonna go like just in the middle here, like just coming from that, my front here, going straight across. As you can see, it is higher than the first mark, but lower than the second mark. Just like that. And that actually gives you the illusion that your arch is higher or your eyebrows are higher. Let's go in and connect our dots and you will see what I'm talking about.
Thank you.
Blending and setting with a brush versus a beauty blender. Which one's better? I'll answer that question at the end of the video, but for now, let's talk about technique. That's the part that actually matters the most. So as far as my concealer, I like to let it sit for a little bit before I actually start blending it. Letting it sit for a little bit just makes it get a little bit thicker so that it is easier to blend. Imagine trying to blend something that's like watery or runny. Yeah, that doesn't sound blendable. But imagine trying to blend something that's a bit thicker. Okay, sounds blendable, right? Right, right. Another thing that's also really important is to start blending from the outsides, like the edges first. Make sure the edges are blended before you start moving up. And another thing that you'll notice is that I don't put the concealer directly underneath my under eyes. I give a little space, and that is because you want to blend up to your under eyes. Because a lot of us get under eye creasing, a good way to avoid like the most creasing under your eyes is to not put the concealer directly under your eyes and to blend up to your eyes. Another thing I like to do is create some structure right next to my nose using my concealer. This is going to serve as like a reverse contour because I don't ever actually contour my nose. And another really important tip when blending concealer is just light taps. Like, you really do not need to like blend that hard. You really do not need to like be super aggressive. The harder the tap, the less blended your concealer is going to look. I don't know how to explain. I don't know if that makes sense, but as you can see, I'm going pretty fast, you know, but the taps are still very, very light. So really take that into consideration. One difference that I can definitely notice right now between the beauty blender and the brush is that I'm able to blend faster with the beauty blender. So I guess you could say the beauty blender is like more beginner friendly, but the brush just gives you a more airbrushed look. It definitely takes a lot more skill and a lot more patience, but I like the brush. I've just started recently using the brush. I'm using this BK Beauty brush. I really like this brush. I just recently started doing it like a month ago, and I've been doing my makeup like that ever since, because it just really, really gives. I think the brush gives you, like I said, a more airbrushed look, and it just looks more like professionally done, if that makes sense. I feel like the beauty blender is something that I would use when I just need to like quickly do my makeup and I just don't want to waste any time. I don't know if you guys can tell, but I feel like the brush side looks like it has more coverage. It's a very slight difference, but I definitely noticed this. Okay, so now we're doing blush. Same thing. We're gonna do beauty blender on one side and brush on one side. With the blush, blending with the beauty blender and the brush, I feel like it's the same thing. The reason why the beauty blender side has like quote unquote less coverage is because, you know, the beauty blender, like, it soaks up the product a little bit, so it's gonna soak up some of the product and leave some of the product on your face. As you can see, with the blush you're able to see it better. Look at the brush side. Like, I'm keeping all that product on my face. Like, all that product is getting on my face. It looks a lot more pigmented on this side, you know what I mean? I even found myself taking the product from the brush side and bringing it over to the beauty blender side just to make them both even and both just as intense. Okay, so now we're gonna set. Same thing, beauty blender versus brush. With the beauty blender, I like to tap some of the product and then tap it off at the back of my hand, and then I start setting. So this is the time when the fact that the beauty blender soaks up a bit of product comes in handy, because you're not gonna have all that powder like on your face. It's gonna soak up some of the powder and you're gonna get the rest on your face. And when it comes to powder, I think less is more. So now for the brush, what I do is tap into the powder and then I just dust, and then I just start setting. With powder, I like to build it up, so like a little bit at a time. As you can see already, you can see that the powder is a lot more intense on this side because I'm using the brush. Like I said, it's gonna give you all that product on your face, and I think that's why the beauty blender is more beginner friendly, because it moderates the amount of product that goes on your face. So I think that for beginners, I would start off with the beauty blender, and then once you perfect your skills, then go and move on to the brush and give it a try. But let me know what you guys think in the comments. Which do you prefer? Bye.